Hey, what's up guys? Sean Nalawani here of bodytransformationtruth.com. And in this video, I want to talk a little bit about the issue of creatine and hair loss, which is a potential creatine side effect that has been discussed quite a bit over the past few years. So does creatine cause baldness or is this just a myth? Now, the exact causes of male pattern baldness aren't fully understood, and I'm definitely not an expert on that particular subject, but it does seem to be pretty closely linked to a compound called DHT, or dihydrotestosterone. And in people who are sensitive to DHT because of genetic reasons, nutrients are basically blocked off from being absorbed by the hair follicles, and this causes them to shrink over time. So back in 2009, there was a study done on rugby players to see how creatine affects levels of DHT in the blood. One group did a standard 25 gram per day loading phase for 1 week, followed by 2 weeks at a maintenance dose of 5 grams. And the other group was just given pure glucose. And at the end of the study, it was shown that in the group who did supplement with the creatine, there was a 56% increase in DHT levels after the first week, and that dropped off to 40% after the 2 weeks at a maintenance dose. So that study is basically the main evidence that we have on this topic, and everything related to creatine and hair loss ultimately comes from this one particular study. Now, it definitely is interesting, but let me give you a few important points to consider before making any hard conclusions here. Number one, again, this is just one single study and the results have never actually been replicated. And studies show varying results for different things all the time. So definitely keep that in mind. Number two, DHT levels dropped by 16% after the creatine dose was reduced. And since the study was only 3 weeks long, it is possible that those levels would have continued to drop over time. 25 grams is a lot to take in 1 day. And as I've discussed many times before, there's really no need at all for a creatine loading phase. We really don't know what the results would have been like if the study had carried on for a longer period of time or if a lower dose was used right from the start. Point number three, hormone levels do fluctuate quite a bit over any given 24-hour period, and we don't actually know if the DHT levels were measured at the same time every day. Number four, we don't have any information about the specific training or nutrition programs that were followed, and research has actually shown that intense training on its own can actually cause an increase in DHT. So even if the training program wasn't the sole cause for the increase, it still could have played a role. And number five, yes, you will see forum threads with guys saying that they started supplementing with creatine and then they experienced hair loss as a result. But given the millions of people who supplement with creatine all around the world who would have been prone to hair loss no matter what, it's obvious just based on coincidence alone that some lifters would see what looks like a connection between the two, even if there really isn't an actual connection there. So I would definitely take those reports with a grain of salt. So bottom line, does creatine cause hair loss and balding in men? Well, the short answer is that we really don't know for sure. I wish I could give a definite guideline here, but like with many issues when it comes to fitness supplements, the answers are not black and white. But that said, my overall advice would be this. First off, if you currently have a strong hairline with a full head of hair and hair loss doesn't run in your family, then I really wouldn't worry about it, and that's because it's not necessarily an increase in DHT levels itself that causes hair loss, but instead it's how sensitive your body is to that DHT based on your genetics. So even if there is a link between creatine and baldness, it would only be an issue of concern for guys who are genetically prone to it in the first place. And secondly, if early hair loss does run in your family or you are already noticing it yourself, then it's really up to you to just take the evidence that is available here and make your own decision. I personally don't consider this one study to be a serious cause for alarm because of the facts that I just mentioned. It is just one study after all, but it is up to you to just weigh out the possibilities for yourself. One thing I would mention though is that if you do decide to use creatine and you want to absolutely minimize the risk here, then just stick to a lower dose of 3 grams per day just to be on the safe side. because even 3 grams per day is still going to allow for maximum creatine benefits in most people. So thanks for watching this video lesson. I hope you found the information useful here today. For more science-based, no-nonsense training nutrition and supplementation advice to maximize your muscle building and your fat burning progress, along with concrete step-by-step plans that you can follow, make sure to head over to bodytransformationtruth.com and grab my complete body transformation blueprint system by clicking the icon at the top of the video or by using the link in the description box below. If you did enjoy the video, as always, please make sure to hit the like button, leave a comment, and subscribe to stay up to date on future videos, and make sure to check out my official blog over at seannal.com for all of my latest articles, tips, and other updates. Talk to you again soon.